Hi, it's Jason at Golf Principles here in the studio in Abridge in Essex. Want to talk to you a little bit about putting and the controversy about anchoring, not anchoring, going on and stuff like that. Obviously, there's been big stuff about Langer and McCarron touching or anchoring, whatever you want to call it. But if you do have putting sort of things, you want to try different grips, different strokes, I'll give you a couple of ideas what you can and can't do. Obviously, you've seen Justin using the flat cap grip for a while now. There's three styles. There's a counterbalance one with a weight at the bottom, which is 100 grams, 110 grams. That's really heavy. Then you've got the standard flat cat here, which you can have a position up like that or with thumbs down. Now, that's nothing new in that. That was a two-thumb grip from back in the day. It's a little bit better than that in terms of size and feel, but conceptually it's the same. But I want to talk to you about how you stroke the putter and what you're doing with momentum and forces. The key when you putt is to try and feel that naturally the momentum is swinging the putter. Clearly you've got to line it up, you've got to be able to hit the intended line you want with the right speed you want. But fundamentally when you stroke, what you're trying to feel is that the pivot point is the top of the grip. So if you're making a putting stroke with your shoulders, you're trying to use the pivot point as the top of the chest, if you like, or you know, across the sternum. Now, if you don't like that feel, it feels a bit robotic or wooden, a la Rory at the moment, trying to almost feel like he's almost like a robot, and you're trying to get more flow to it, speed, I guess, is the best exponent of it, you can go left below right. That locks the arm in with the shaft, that gets the right wrist set into a good position, and it keeps the pivot point now as the right wrist, or slightly inside the palm, the fleshy part in there. So you almost feel like you're going to push it into the hole. So you start with this position here, and you feel that this pressure point stays consistently the same. If you feel that it feels a little bit blocky, which it can do, your speed when he putts, if he misses it, he will tend to block it. You can go into the cradle or the prayer grip. Prayer, cradle, it's a similar sort of concept. You're trying to keep the forces opposing each other. So if you go cradle like that, and you go, or classically two-thumb-esque, for a phrase, and you wrap your hands around at the bottom like the old kids' church thing. The key there is to actually let the putter head swing and use the top of the grip as a pivot point and not to move that too much. That's going to move a little bit clearly, but the head's going to move much more. That's going to feel a little bit almost like you've got to lose control to gain control theory. So if this top of the grip doesn't move too much and the head is moving in momentum, you're using the laws of physics to swing. That is a good way to putt. It will feel a little bit flippy for some of you out there who are used to being a little bit wooden, but once you get used to it, it's a very good way to feel the ball into the hole. If you've got a good surface to putt on, good greens, it's a great way to putt. So go try it maybe. If you want to try something different and you're putting, you know, your ball striking is pretty good, but your putting's letting you down, it's such a big part of the game. You have to get it worked out. You know, you can go to DeChambeau. You can go whatever you want, right? You can even go to the sort of Langer-esque, well, almost. But you have to be very aware that what you're trying to do is get the right speed for the right line. And maybe if you want to try that type of grip, don't be frightened to do it, and maybe put something like that on the flat cat so you can have a little bit of different hand position. So you have flexibility, but don't be frightened to feel like you're almost releasing the putter head. You know, a yip, if you want to call it something, is where the handle is moving more than the head. You watch people at the golf club who give it the old, whoa. It's the handle that's going first, not the club head. You know, the guys, the classic, whoa, missed that one, sir. It's the handle that's going backwards and forwards. It's not the club head, right? The club head has to swing, all right? So take that point on board. And any questions, give us a shout at Abridge or Basingstoke. We're happy to help you.